Father, we thank you very much once again for this morning. We bless you for what you have been doing since you were here. Thank you for the opportunity to worship. And thank you because you are sitting at the right hand of God, pleading our cause. You don't behave to us as we behave. You know our infirmities. And you know we are ordinary dust. And that's why we come to you for help. That we take care of all our infirmities. And make your word to be perfect in us. That your purpose in our life will be fulfilled. You don't want to come to this wilderness and perish in the wilderness. But to live with you forever. This morning, minister to our souls.
Amen.
Let us understand.
Amen.
Ignite our spirit.
Amen.
Let the love for you and for your word grow in us.
Amen.
You left all to make us what we are today. In 2 Corinthians chapter 3, chapter 5,
it
said, it is the love of God that is compelling us. That is, if somebody has died for us, we were all dead. And the love of God is now compelling us to do the will of God and to plead that others should believe in Christ. Let that love grow in us.
Amen.
Let that love compel us to do your will.
Amen.
Let that love compel us to rescue the perishing. Some other people have worked to make us what we are today. Help us to do our own part. And you, God, will take the glory. In Jesus' name we pray.
Pliny.
God knows all about you. Your regret will be over. In Jeremiah chapter 20, verse 18. Let's read. That has been the main topic. We are on the last point, but let us quickly read that. It was Prophet Jeremiah that asked causes to complain before God.
Let us Jeremiah lo nsaroye niwaju Olorun nibi yi.
E se ti mi fi jade kuro ninu iya mi. Lati ri irora ati osi ati lati pari ojo mi ni tiju.
And the Bible declares that we were born in the flesh and we were born to the world of trouble.
Iwe mimo je ko ye wa wi pe abi wa gege bi eniyan a si bi wa sinu wahala.
And we meet trouble every day. But this man of God got to a point that the ministry was becoming too tough for him to bear. And he was seeing a lot of trouble upon trouble. He has to say, should I end my life with regret? You will never end your life with regret in Jesus'
name.
Amen. He was, however, comforted. And he had a very successful ministry. Don't forget that at times he was thrown into prison. He even God asked him to write all the messages in a book. He had a secretary that wrote all the things in the book. And he was asked to go and read it in the presence of the elders and in the presence of the king of Jerusalem. And the secretary went there to read it.
akowe yi si lo sibe lati ka.
And the king was sitting, it was a winter period, he was beside fire warming himself.
Oba joko lori akete re o je akoko tutu o ya o yena.
And he asked them to bring the book.
Oni kan mu iwe na wa.
And he asked them to cut it and throw it into the fire.
O wa pase pe kan mu iwe na kan ge si wewe kan ko si
na. And we know how disturbing that could be.
E mo bi inu iranse Olorun yi a se
da si. God called himself, go and write the book again.
Olorun tun pe iwe tan tun nina yi tun lo tuko.
Write it again.
Tun tuko.
What I said will come to pass.
Ohun ti mo ti so yo wa si mu se.
And yet he carried out his ministry to the end.
Olorun si ran lowo o sase pari ise
ise. So stop complaining.
Iwo na si wa aruye ni ohun ti mo so.
Stop complaining.
Si wa aruye.
The Lord will see you through life.
Olorun amu ola aja.
God purpose for you will be fulfilled.
Iti Olorun fun aye re ase.
The last point is where I am. I will not be repeating the previous lectures.
Koko to kayin la wa mi o
said these messages are there for us. You can collect the disc and listen to it either audio or video. And you can always tap us on YouTube. You can see us on Facebook.
Won ti gba eda eko yi sile enikan to ba nife si o le lori awon to ngba sile ko ra boya alawo mo ni abi ti oloro
lasan. Be of help to us.
A je iran lowo fun wa.
If we stop wasting our money on what cannot profit us to eternity.
Ka siwo bi inowo wa si ohun ti o niran wa lowo si ayeraye.
Some of us can spend a lot of time on Facebook and on WhatsApp with other mundane things.
Opolopo wa la le lo si ori ero ayelujara ka ma se I to wu wa nibe ohun ti o ni se wa lanfani.
I think it was the leaders I was talking to, or maybe it was you in the church here. Mm-hmm. That is the cousin of my wife.
Arabirin arakunrin iyawo mi kan ni mo nsoro re loju awon alagba ni
boya
inu ijo nbi ni mo ti
so. The man witness.
Ara ijo bi ti won daruko.
During this corona crisis.
Lakoko wahala to ba gugu
agbaye yi. He cut off all other WhatsApps. All where it could be wasting money on wasting his data.
Awon ibi to ti le ma fowo sofo o di gbogbo re pa.
Because in their ministry they asked them to go on Zoom.
Tori ni bi ise ranse ti won won ni kan lo sultan ti ma wo ara won ninu ijo won.
They ask them to go on Zoom, so they will spend data and the teacher will be teaching and everybody will be connected to them on Zoom.
Oluko ni a ma ko won ibi to ni kaluku ba wa to ba ti darapo mo won ajo ma
wo. And you know there are illiterates like you, those who cannot read, in even there are so many Jehovah Witnesses.
Ke mo ipe ai mo ye awon ti o ni ore ofe ati kawe laarin won na nibe.
And all of them were carried to the Zoom.
Gbogbo won na si nse nkan ta n so.
I don't know whether they have not even resumed going to meetings now. I don't know whether they have resumed, but initially when they asked to start, they said they are not meeting yet. They remain on Zoom.
Mi o ti e mo boya won ti pada lo ma josin ninu ile josin tori gba ton ni kan bere won ni won ti se tan pe yi ton se yen na si ma se.
And everybody will carry his own tablet on Zoom and
oni kaluku agbe pele bere dani a si ma.
So you have all opportunities to listen to us and to collect our messages. Not all congregation have the opportunity we have in this church.
Ani ore ofe bayi lati gba eda iwasun wa abi lati teti si wa lori agbagbe ki se gbogbo ijo abi ki se gbogbo eniyan lo ni wa
fani dani. You don't listen to what the Bible says.
Ta ba si ti teti si ohun si iwe mimo wi.
You will do what the world is saying.
Ohun ti aye nse abi ohun ti aye nso la ma se.
All that is going on your radio, it is what you will be using to live your life.
Eyi ta n gbo lori ero asoro magbesi la ma fi gbe igbe aye wa.
It doesn't affect anybody more than you.
Ki se pe o kuku ba elomiran na ju ti wa lo.
It is only you that it will affect.
Awa gan la ba ju.
It has nothing to do with God.
Oni kankan se pelu Olorun.
God will only say he has done what he should do for you.
Olorun a ko so pe ohun ti se yi to ye ko ohun se
fun. Only left for us.
O wa ku si wa lowo.
May God help us.
Olorun aran wa lowo.
I say may God help us.
Olorun aran wa lowo.
So at last You will sing to the Lord and give all praises to him.
Leke gbogbo re wa korin wa si fi yin fun Olorun.
Jeremiah chapter 20 verse 13a.
We Jeremiah ori ogun ese iketa abala kini ese iketa.
Jeremiah chapter 20.
E korin si Oluwa.
Yes.
Enyi Oluwa. Nitori ti o gba okan talaka kuro lowo awon olusebubu.
The Lord that rescue us from the hand of the wicked will continue to rescue us, and you will praise the Lord in Jesus' name.
Amen.
I've
mentioned about three among the four major reasons why you will praise God and sing to his glory.
I thank
God in his law have taken the cup of fury from our hand.
Moni Olorun o ti gba go ibinu kuro lowo wa.
I also said your captivity is over.
Mo tun so wi pe ojo igbekun wa ti dopin.
And I said number three, that our salvation is complete because Jesus is sitting at the right hand of God.
Moni ise irapada wa eto igbala wa pe ase pe ni tori pe Jesu joko lowo
Olorun. I said you will praise the Lord because you will enter into new things altogether.
Moni wa yin Olorun tori pe wa wonu ohun tuntun lo lapapo.
The beginning of a new order.
Ibere otun.
Last week when I was talking, I said this lecture is three dimensional.
Lose to koja nigba ti mo nsoro mo ni eko yi oloju meji ni.
I said entering into new things is actually talking after our ordeal in this world.
Mo ni wi wonu ohun otun lo iyen tumo si eyin gba ta ba pari irin ajo wa ni bi.
You enter into a new things as individual.
A wonu ohun tuntun lo gege bi eyo enikankan wa.
You enter into a new things as a family.
A wonu ohun otun lo gege bi ebi.
As a church, you enter into a new things altogether.
Gege bi ijo a wonu ohun tuntun lo lapapo.
So going and that when we enter into a new things in all eternity, it will be a time we will begin to give God the glory.
Nígbà tí gbogbo wa bá wọnú ohun ọ̀tun lọ ní ayérayé, a jẹ́ àkókò tá a máa fi ògo fún Ọlọ́run.
You will even forget that you have ever come to the world.
Mo sọ wípé a tilẹ̀ ti gbàgbé pé a wá sínú ayé eléyìí gan rí.
And I said Christ gave us a simple illustration.
Mo ní Jésù ń ṣe àlàyé rẹ̀ kékeré fún wa.
That a pregnant woman will enter into his joy or into her joy after childbirth.
Pe obirin to robi abi to loyun to ba nrobi a wonu ayo lo ni kete to ba ti
bimo tan. From day one of pregnancy until the last day, until the day of delivery, a woman is in trouble.
Ni kete ti obirin ba ti loyun titi di igba ti yo bimo, inu wahala lobirin wa.
She's really in trouble.
Inu wahala ni.
That is why we normally say congratulations after childbirth.
Ohun la fi ma ki won ku orire nigba tan ba bimo tan.
The heavens and angels will congratulate you when you leave this world.
Àwọn ọ̀run àti àwọn angẹ́lì á sì kí ọ kú oríire nígbà tó bá kúrò nínú ayé níbí.
You will be given an heroic welcome.
Wọ́n á kí ọ ní ìkí ọba pé o káàbọ̀.
And you will forget that you have ever come to the world.
Wà á sì gbàgbé pé o ti wá sínú ayé yìí gan-an.
I said you will forget you have ever come to this world.
Mo ní wà á gbàgbé pé o tilẹ̀ lanú ayé yìí kọjá.
In other words, you may not even forget that you have ever come to the world.
Léde mìíràn ó sì ṣeé ṣe kó o má tún gbàgbé gan-an
tó wà nínú ayé. If you don't enter into the city of congratulations,
iyen to ba ti wonu ibi tan ti ki oko abo,
you will remember all the agony of the world.
Wa ma ranti iya to ti je ninu aye ni.
And the agony here cannot be compared with the agony of eternity.
Irora ti bi a si le fi we irora aye
raye. What you call suffering today is a child play.
Eyi ta n pe ni iya loni nkan kekere ni.
May you not suffer in eternity.
Ani jiya aye raye loruko Jesu.
That suffering is what Jesus was looking ahead at the Garden of Gethsemane.
Irora yi ni Jesu n wo niwaju ninu ogba Gethsemane.
It was not the agony of the cross that is making him to say, if God wish that he should take the cup away from his hand.
Kì í ṣe ìrora orí igi àgbélébù ni Jesu ń rí tó fi sọ pé ò bá gba agbo kúrò lọ́wọ́ mi.
He was looking ahead at the agony in hell.
Ṣùgbọ́n ó ń wo ìrora tó kúrú dù mí lọ́nà báyìí.
At the agony of the torment in the lake of fire.
Ó ń wo ìrora ìjìyà ti ọ̀run àpáàdì.
But he has taken it all for him to carry the wrath of God upon himself.
Ṣùgbọ́n a ti filé lẹ̀ fun láti wí ìbínú Ọlọ́run
lórí ara rẹ̀. As I used to say, it is only God that is at wrath with man.
Mo ti máa ń sọ pé Ọlọ́run nìkan ló ń bínú sí ènìyàn.
If God remove the wrath from you, nobody can give you problem in the world.
Ti Ọlọ́run ba ti mú ìbínú kúrò lórí ọ̀rọ̀ rẹ̀, kò sí ẹnìkan tó lè fún ọ ní
ìṣòro nínú ayé. And it is that wrath of God that made Jesus to come down to the world.
Torí ìbínú Ọlọ́run yìí gan ni Jésù ń ṣe sọ̀kalẹ̀ wá sáyé.
So he's the only one in the book of God that will suffer last the wrath of God.
Òun ni ẹyọ ẹni tó kẹ́yìn tó yẹ kó jìyà ìbínú Ọlọ́run.
In the mind of God, God does not expect any human on earth to go into that wrath after Christ.
Nínú ọkàn Ọlọ́run lọ́hùn-ún, kò sí nínú àkọsílẹ̀ rẹ̀ pé kí ẹnikẹ́ni kó tún wọnú ìjìyà yọ lẹ́yìn Jésù.
He took the cup of bitterness.
Ó gba ago ìbínú, ago ìkorò.
He took the cup of wrath.
Ó ti gba ago ìbínú.
He entered into agony.
Ó wọnú ìrora.
He entered into darkness.
Ó wọnú òkùnkùn.
May you not enter into darkness anymore.
Àní wọnú òkùnkùn lọmọ lórúkọ Jésù.
We are all in darkness. He came to our darkness to draw
us out. Gbogbo wa la wà nínú òkùnkùn tẹ́lẹ̀tẹ́lẹ̀, ó wá wọnú òkùnkùn wa.
He was mindful of the glory ahead.
Ó ń wo ògo tó ń bọ̀ níwájú.
And that's why the Bible talks of his suffering and the glory that we follow.
Ìdí nìyí tí Bíbélì fi sọ̀rọ̀ ìyá rẹ̀ àti ògo tó ń bọ̀ wá tẹ̀lé.
So in other words, the suffering of all of us in Adam.
Ohun tí mò ń sọ ni pé ìyá wa nínú Ádámù.
And the glory that will follow us if we believe in Christ.
Àti ògo tó máa tẹ̀lé tá a bá gba Jésù.
Let it be registered in your mind.
Ẹ jẹ́ kó kalẹ̀ nínú ọkàn
wa. God asks that after this your suffering, you will enter into glory.
Pé ó ti wà nínú ọkàn Ọlọ́run pé nínú ìyá ayé eléyìí àwọn inú ògo.
Before I continue my lecture.
Kí n tó tẹ̀síwájú
lórí ẹ̀kọ́ yìí. Romans chapter 8 verse 18 will be a summary of what I'm trying to say. Romans chapter 8.
Ìwé Rome orí kẹjọ.
Verse 18 alone.
Ẹsẹ̀ ìkejì.
Nítorí mo ṣírò rẹ̀ pé.
Yes.
Ìyá ìgbà ìsinsìnyí kò yẹ láti fi ṣe àkàwé ògo tẹ́ ó fi hàn nínú wa.
A revelation from the mind of our apostle that it is not that he's saying we don't suffer, we will suffer, we are in agony, but whatever agony you are passing through here.
Ìfihàn nìyí láti ọ̀dọ̀ apostle wa. Kì í ṣe pé bóyá níjìyà ṣùgbọ́n ìyàkiyà yòówù tá a bá là kọjá nínú ayé eléyìí.
Cannot be compared with the glory that is ahead.
A lè fi wé ògo tó wà níwájú.
May you enter into that glory.
Àwọnú ògo lórúkọ Jésù.
May you enter into that glory.
Àdúrà sí pé àwọnú ògo lórúkọ Jésù.
This is a city of suffering.
Ìlú ìyà níbí yìí.
Some are here without eyes.
Àwọn mìíràn wà níbi tí wọn ò lójú.
Some are here without ears.
Àwọn mìíràn wà tí wọn ò létí.
Some are here they cannot even procreate.
Àwọn mìíràn tilẹ̀ wà tí wọn ò lè ṣe.
There are so many problems and challenges in this world.
Àìmọye ìpèníjà àti wàhálà ló kúnnú ayé
lẹ́yìn. The little one that comes your way is minor.
Ìwọ̀nba èyí tá a bá là kọjá nínú rẹ̀ kékeré ni.
It's minor to the glory that is coming ahead.
Kékeré ni tá a bá ní ká fi ṣe àfiwé ògo tó ń bọ̀.
The moment you cross the river.
Ní kété tá a bá ti rí omi kọjá sọ̀hún.
The moment you cross the river.
Ní kété tá a bá ti kọjá omi sọ̀hún.
And you get into that city.
Tá a wọnú ìlú ni lọ.
Say you cross River Jordan and you get to the land of Canaan.
Bí ìgbà tá a bá kọjá odò Jordan tá a bọ́ sílẹ̀ Canaan ni.
You begin, you will not eat manna again.
Nígbà náà ni manna ṣíwọ́.
Manna is the food of the wilderness.
Oúnjẹ aginjù ni manna.
Remember, manna can be used to produce any type of food.
Ẹ má gbàgbé pé ohunkóhun la lè fi manna yìí ṣe.
Manna was the food of heaven, the food of angels for them in the wilderness.
Bó tilẹ̀ jẹ́ pé oúnjẹ angẹ́lì ni fún wọn nínú angẹ́lì nínú agidi.
I can compare that to all your enjoyment in this world.
Mo lè fi eléyìí wé gbogbo ìgbádùn tá a bá lè sọ nínú ayé yìí.
You have a jet, you have mansions, you have a chain of children, you have the best doctors, you have all you could have in this world, that is manna.
O ní ọkọ̀ ojú òfúrufú, o ní ilé aráràbarà, o ní oríṣiríṣi ohun mèremère, o bí ẹgbẹ̀rún ọmọ, mo fi gbogbo eléyìí, mo fi gbé manna yìí.
That is the food in the wilderness.
Èso ní aginjù ni.
Food in the wilderness.
Oúnjẹ ní aginjù.
That is manna in the wilderness.
Ìyẹn ni manna ní aginjù.
But the moment you cross over. into the land of Canaan, you will begin to eat the fruit of the land. So you will remember when the Israelites were passing through the wilderness, they were even complaining of the manna.
There is nothing
you have in this world that will not bring sorrow with it. That's why I call it manna. All you call off in the world, you can say congratulations today. Before 2 days, that thing will give you sadness or sorrow. It will bring trouble to you tomorrow. That very thing you are rejoicing today will bring its trouble to you. That is how this world is constructed. And there is nothing you can do about it. Because there is nothing here that can last forever. You too cannot last forever. But the moment you cross River Jordan and you come to the city of God, you will begin to eat the fruit of the land. It will be new things all together. In the same way,
back on now,
you know, before they entered the land of Canaan, they were circumcised. They removed the foreskin, they were circumcised. And that circumcision is a change of heart. In other words, the moment you have complete change of heart and you are really committed to Christ, in your journey from here before you get to heaven, it will be new things altogether. Your former sufferings and agony as an unbeliever, as an uncircumcised person, will be over. Why not allow God to circumcise your heart? Circumcision is not physical. It's not just church attendance. It's not just religious activity. It's opening your heart to the word of God. And the word of God has a place in you. And you are hungry. Let me quote the language of a man, one of the books I read as a young man. You are hungry for reality. Thank you very much. You are hungry for reality. When you are hungry for reality, you will be fed with reality. Blessed are those who are hungry and thirst for righteousness. They shall be satisfied. There is no satisfaction in this world until the word of God enter you. And the moment you are circumcised, you will begin new things altogether. And your life will begin to be a life of praises to God.
So
new things altogether is packaged for you.
It's
packaged for you when you are born again. When you are really committed to Christ, and you don't play with the word of God, you begin to move from, let me quote the Bible, 2 Corinthians chapter 3 verse 18 will satisfy me. 2 Corinthians chapter 3 verse 18 will satisfy me.
And all of us,
yes,
as with unveiled face, continue to behold in the word of God, as in a mirror, the
we
glory of the Lord.
To behold in the word of God, as in a mirror, the face of Christ. You are reading.
Are constantly being transfigured.
Thank you.
Into his own very image.
You continue to behold in the word of God as if you are looking at a mirror. You behold Christ in the word of God as if you are looking at a mirror.
Ṣùgbọ́n gbogbo wa ń wo ògo Olúwa láìsí ìbòjú bí ẹni pé nínú àwò jíjí.
You get the message. You begin to look at Christ. You don't see Christ until you go to the Bible. And when you begin to behold him in the scriptures, you will be transformed from one glory to another glory.
Ibe lati ma yiwa pada lati
ogun kan si ogun. The Lord of glory will change all things together in your life.
Olorun ogo a ti wa yi ohun gbogbo pada ninu aye wa.
All things will begin to change.
Ohun gbogbo a ma yi pada.
Everything in your life will change from one glory to another.
Ohun gbogbo a ma yi pada ninu aye wa lati ogun kan si ogun keji.
That's why it's important to place the Bible before you.
Ohun lo sese pataki ka ma wo iwe mimo ni gbogbo
igba. That's why it's important for you to read.
Ohun lo sese pataki ka ma ka ka si
to be accustomed to the Bible. Transformation or change or new things does not exist on the street of Elisha or on the street of London or the street of America.
Iyipada si rere iyipada si ohun otun ko si ni oju popo Elisha ko si ni oju
popo America. You cannot get transformation in the market. You cannot get it in the market.
A le ri iyipada ninu
oja. You cannot get it where you are pursuing naira and kobon, you are pursuing dollar.
A le ri nibi ta tin le owo
kiri. You cannot get transformation or change to a new things when you go into politics.
Iyipada si ohun otun a le ba pade ninu eto
osi. You are transformed according to verse 18. You are transformed when you behold God in the word of God as in a mirror.
And ye aye wa pada nigba ta ba nwo Olorun ninu iwe mimo gege bi awon
igi. You will be changed. It is a thing that God cannot be do. God must change you.
Olorun o le shall I you wa pada nigba ta ba ti
just happen.
Ohun tuntun gbadọ sele si wa.
It just has to happen.
O ni lati sele.
How it happens I cannot know. I don't know.
Bi o si wa sele ni mi o wa le shall I
you. It just has to happen.
Sugbon ni lati sele.
God has to transform you.
Olorun lati ye aye wa pada.
God has to change your status.
O ni lati yi ipo
wa pada. Your condition must change.
Ipo wa ni lati yi pada.
It is not your activity that will change your status.
Ki se akitiyan wa la wa yi pada
o. It is not your religion that will change your status.
Ki se esin wa la yi pada o.
It is not whatever you do that will change your status.
Ki se ohun ta ba se la yi pada
o. It is the word of God.
Sugbon
the word of God.
Oro Olorun.
Committed reading, beholding Christ in the word of God as if in a mirror. And God, the God of the Lord Jesus Christ, will transform you from one state to another glory.
Ifarajiwa kika oro Olorun a si ma wo o a ma wo Olorun ninu oro re bi awo si.
So how many of you are looking for new things?
Melo ninu wa lo
nse wa won. When you see it will vanish, it will vanish, it will vanish.
Ta ba ni kan bi aye yi fun won igba die ni.
It was, I used to say it regularly.
Mo ma so
lori kori who learned it in a hard way. He learned in a hard way. Don't allow God to teach you in a hard way.
E ma je ko Olorun ko ko wa lona to le o.
You remember the man was God's servant.
E ranti pe ranse Olorun le
ti so. God chose him.
Olorun yan.
God appointed him.
Olorun yan.
To rule all the nations of the world.
Lati je gaba lori gbogbo agbaye.
He wanted to discipline Israel and he brought Israel under his captivity.
O Olorun mo mo fe bi aja awon Israel lo fi ko won si abe
yi. Now God will place effect his hand has made it.
O wa ro wi pe owo ohun ti te.
And that's what so many of us do.
Nkan to polopo wa ma nse
ni. Celebrate our achievement. What have we achieved?
A ma n se ajoyo lori nkan ta ni.
Celebrate what we have made.
Ohun ta ti se.
And that was what killed him and sent him into the bush for 7 years.
Ohun to le oba yi to pa to le si inu go fun
odi odi eke ni. He said, is it not Babylon that I've established by my own hand?
O wa rin lori aketere oni ki se Babylon ti mo ti owo mi
ko lele. And the word came and the word from the watchers came. It is you that is giving that animal's heart to be given to you. Go into the bush. Let 7 times pass over you until you realize it is the Most High that gives.
Oro na si wa lati odo awon alore pe iwo ko ni ati so oro na fun pe igba meje yo koja lo lori re a o si yi okan re pada si okan eranko wa si gbe ninu igbe fun odun meje.
I often told you,
mo ti ma so fun wa,
be careful of 2 important events.
Ka kiye si ka ma sora fun ohun meji kan,
particularly when you have made some little progress and you are celebrating whatever you call an achievement.
Papa ta ba ni tesiwaju nipa ti ara to dabi eni pe owo wa te.
Who is on the throne? Who did it?
Talent to wa lori ite ta lo se.
You will show who did it by your actions. By your action.
Wa fi han ninu iwa re eni to se fun o.
God will know it is.
To ba je Olorun ni wa fi han ninu iwa.
If it is you, you will be on the throne.
To ba je iwo ni wa joko.
Watch out. Watch out.
Kiye sara.
When you suffer and you are passing through agony,
don't lie rura koja.
Watch out for your words, for your actions.
Fun oro re, fun ise re.
Because that suffering is momentary.
Tori igiya be fun iwon
die ni. Some are to try you. So
opolopo nu iya yi lati don wa wo ni.
To know what is in your mind.
Lati mo to wa ninu okan.
Like the Bible says, He gave them manna in the wilderness.
Gẹ́gẹ́ bí Bẹ́lí ṣe sọ pé ó fún wọn ní manna ní aginjù.
To know what was in their mind.
Láti mọ ohun tó wà ní ọkàn wọn.
He sent snake. Can you send a snake to your child?
Ó rán ejò. Ṣé o lè rán ejò sí ọmọ rẹ?
He didn't give them water. Can you do that? Can you do that to your child?
Fún wọn lómi. Ṣé ìwọ lè ṣe irú rẹ sí ọmọ rẹ?
He wanted to know what is in their mind.
Ṣùgbọ́n gbogbo eléyìí ó ń ṣe láti mọ ohun tó wà nínú ọkàn wọn.
I'm still reading now. I'm on the book of Numbers. I started recently again.
Ìwé numéri ni mo wà, mo ṣẹ̀ṣẹ̀ bẹ̀rẹ̀ rẹ̀ láìpẹ́ yìí.
In fact, when I begin to look at it, I saw.
Nígbà tí mò ń wò, mo wá rí pé.
God has all reasons to say these people have tormented me even more than 10 times.
Ọlọ́run ní gbogbo ọ̀nà láti sọ pé àwọn ènìyàn wọ̀nyí wọ́n ti dán mi wò ju ìgbà mẹ́wàá lọ
pàápàá. Even after he told them to turn back and walk.
Lẹ́yìn ìgbà tó tilẹ̀ wá sọ fún wọn pé kán máa yí ko káàkiri.
They complained until they got to the land.
Wọ́n sì ń ṣàròyé títí tán fi wọ ilẹ̀ náà ni.
It is after he asked them to be turning around that they get to the water of Meribah. And they said, Aaron, Moses, you are here to destroy us.
Ẹ̀yìn ìgbà tán ní Tọ́lọ́run ní kan padà kán máa yípo náà dé ibi odò omi Meribah. Ibẹ̀ náà ti ké mọ́ Moses àti Aaron pé òwò òmù kò wà sí láti pa wá.
Moses could not listen to the word of God. Moses could not listen to the word of God.
Mose ò lè tẹ́tí sí ọ̀rọ̀ Ọlọ́run.
That's where I'm going. The word of God is the vital thing that will make you.
Ọ̀rọ̀ Ọlọ́run ni ohun tó ṣe pàtàkì jù láti mú wa ró. Kì í ṣe ọ̀rọ̀ ènìyàn.
And the word of God will bring new things out in your life.
Ọ̀rọ̀ Ọlọ́run láti mú ohun tuntun jáde nínú ayé.
You are created to go into the new city.
Adáwa láti wọ ìlú ọ̀tún lọ.
New people for the new city.
Àwọn ènìyàn ọ̀tún fún ìlú tuntun.
New things, new life, new fellowship. New life for the new city.
Ohun tuntun, ìgbé ayé tuntun,
ìyàpọ̀ tuntun fún ìlú tuntun.
Kì í ṣe ògbólógbò ọkùnrin fún ìlú tuntun.
Not old character for the new city.
Kì í ṣe ògbólógbò ìwà fún ìlú tuntun.
Not old behavior for the new city.
Kì í ṣe ògbólógbò ìhùwàsí fún ìlú tuntun.
So God must begin new things in your life now.
Ọlọ́run ní láti bẹ̀rẹ̀ ohun ọ̀tún nínú ayé wa lọ́wọ́lọ́wọ́.
And those new things will lead you into the new things altogether in
heaven. Ohun tuntun yìí láti mú wa wọnú ohun tuntun lọ lápapọ̀.
That's why I used to say you, the beginning of our new things has started the day you are circumcised in the heart.
Ìbẹ̀rẹ̀ ohun ọ̀tún ti bẹ̀rẹ̀ nínú ayé wa lọ́jọ́ tá a ti kọ́ wa ní ìlà ọkàn.
You are hungry to sit down and read the Bible and you are calm under the word of God. It's the beginning of a new order in your life.
Ní kété tí òun gbẹ ọ̀rọ̀ Ọlọ́run bá ti ń gbẹ wá láti jókòó láti kà á ìbẹ̀rẹ̀ ohun ọ̀tún.
Because by the time Jesus died on the cross.
Nígbà tí Jésù kú lórí igi àgbélébùú.
Anybody who embraced that new thing when he came comes to the cross.
Ẹnikẹ́ni tó bá ti wá sí igi àgbélébùú tó rọ̀ mọ́ ohun ọ̀tún.
Like I used to tell you, you are saying bye bye to evil days.
À ń sọ pé ó dìgbò ṣe ọjọ́ búburú.
Evil days will never come to pass in your life.
Ọjọ́ búburú òní wá sí ayé wa mọ́.
Days of agony will be over.
Ọjọ́ ìrora ó kọjá lọ.
Days of diseases will be over.
Ọjọ́ àìsàn ó kọjá lọ.
Days of sadness will be over.
Ọjọ́ ìbànújẹ́ kọjá lọ.
God is opening a new book of record for you.
Ọlọ́run ń ṣíwèé tuntun kan wá.
And from that day, new things in your life.
Láti ọjọ́ náà ìbẹ̀rẹ̀ ohun ọ̀tún nínú ayé wa.
So as you journey in life to heaven, expect new things.
Bá a ṣe rin ìrìnàjò wa láti ayé sí ọ̀run ká máa rí ohun tuntun.
Even when you get into a mountain of difficulties.
Nígbà tá a bá tilẹ̀ dé ibi àwọn òkè tó ṣòro.
Look up.
Wòkè.
That mountain will lead you into a new thing.
Òkè yìí á gbé wa lọ sí ibi ohun mìíràn.
The hardship of today will lead you into a new thing.
Ìnira tó dàbí ìgbé à ń là kọjá lọ́jọ́ òní ohun tuntun ló máa gbé wa wọ̀.
Study the Bible and you will see that is how God works with all the saints in the Bible.
Tá a bá ka Bíbélì a rí pé bó ṣe bá àwọn àyàn fẹ́ rẹ̀ rìn nínú ìwé mímọ́ nìyí.
Behind the cloud there is the rain.
Lẹ́yìn ìṣú dúdú òjò á bẹ̀rẹ̀.
Beside the cloud there is the rain.
Lẹ́yìn ìṣú dúdú òjò á rọ̀.
Behind thick darkness there is the sunshine.
Lẹ́yìn òkùnkùn biribiri ìmọ́lẹ̀ á tàn.
So stop complaining.
Ṣíwọ́ àròyé ni mo sọ.
You will enter into new things altogether.
Wà á wọnú ohun tuntun lọ.
You will enter into new things altogether.
À á wọnú ohun tuntun lọ lápapọ̀.
I say you will enter into new things altogether.
Mo ní ohun tuntun lápapọ̀ ní orúkọ Jésù.
In Revelation chapter 21 verse 5.
Ìwé ìfihàn orí karùn-ún.
Revelation 21 verse 5. Let's read.
Ẹni tí ó jókòó lórí ìtẹ́ ni sì wí pé.
Always underline that language. Somebody
is the
throne here. In two dimensions.
Ìtẹ́níbí yìí ká fojú méjì wò.
Who is on the throne of your heart?
Ta lẹni tó wà lórí ìtẹ́ ọkàn tirẹ̀?
Who is on the throne of your heart?
Ta ló wà lórí ìtẹ́ ọkàn rẹ?
Who is in the throne on the throne in heaven?
Ta lẹni tó wà lórí ìtẹ́ Lọ́run?
Those are the two things you must look at closely.
Ohun méjì ta ní láti kíyèsí.
Are you ruling
Se wo lo nje gaba?
Are you in control?
Se wo lo ndari?
Are you on the throne?
Se wo lo joko?
Who is on the throne?
Ta leni to wa lori ite?
Who is in the throne in heaven?
Ta leni to wa lori ite loke
lohun? Is the person in heaven able to control the whole earth?
Se eni to wa lori ite lohun le dari gbogbo aye?
Does he see you?
Se ori o?
Does he see your family?
Se ori ebi re?
Does he know where you are?
Se o mo bi to wa?
Does he know your beginning and your ending?
Se o mo ibere re ati opin re?
Is the devil on throne?
Se Jesu lo wa lori lori akete ni.
Is the devil on the throne in heaven?
Se Jesu lo wa lori ite lorun.
Answer that question your heart. Is the devil on the throne in heaven?
Se Jesu lo wa lori akoso lorun.
Is it the devil or Jesus?
Se Jesu ni abi Jesu.
Who is controlling your life?
Ta leni to ndari aye re?
Who has authority over your life?
Ta leni to ni ase lori aye re?
Is it the devil or you or Christ?
Jesu iwo abi Jesu.
Who paid the price?
Ta lo san gbese na?
Who was welcomed into heaven?
Ta leni ta kika abo
so? By angels and who was told sit here until all enemies become your footstool?
Ta leni ton fun lase pe joko niyin titi ti a
ri ko ta re se a Jesus
titi se re Jesus ni a
Jesus. If it is the devil, then no new thing will happen to you.
To ba ti je Jesus na kika abo be a je
pe o ton ni sele that God gave a seat to sit down here.
To ba je Jesus na fun ni te pe joko ni bi ba se ku ni
lele. If it is Jesus,
mo to ba ti je
Jesus say it, Jesus Christ, you are on the throne.
Pe ka so pe Jesu o wa lori ite.
Who is on the throne?
Ta lo wa lori ite.
Who is on the throne?
Jesus.
Say it three times. Jesus, you are on the throne.
Pe Jesu o wa lori ite.
Jesus, you are on the throne.
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 You see everything.
Ori ohun gbogbo.
You know my goings and you are my coming out.
O mo iwole ati jade.
You are in control.
Iwo lo nsakoso gbogbo.
Nobody can remove you from that throne.
Ko seni to le si o nipo ni bi
je yi. Because you are on the throne.
Tori pe o wa lori ite.
Because you are on the throne.
Tori pe o wa lori ite.
Everything in my life must be new.
Gbogbo ohun to wa gbogbo ohun to yi mi ka gbodo di otun.
Because Jesus was on the throne.
Tori pe iwo Jesu wa lori ite.
The devil, you are not on the throne.
Esu ko lo wa lori ite.
The devil, you are not on the throne.
Iwo esu ko lo wa lori ite.
Jesus, you are on the throne.
Jesu iwo lo wa lori ite.
Everything in my life must be new.
Ohun gbogbo ninu aye mi gbodo di otun.
Everything in my life must be new.
Ohun gbogbo ninu aye mi gbodo di otun.
Everything new must come out of my life.
Ohun tuntun gbodo je jade ninu aye mi.
Jesus, you are on the throne.
Iwo baba lo wa lori ite.
Because you are on the throne.
Tori pe o wa lori ite.
Everything must be new. Everything must change to the new thing.
Ìyípadà ọ̀tún gbọ́dọ̀ dé bá mi.
In Jesus' name we pray.
Ní orúkọ Jésù ni
a pẹ̀lú. Sit down. You are reading that verse. Now listen to the verse.
Mo sọ gbogbo di ọ̀tún.
Ìbéèrè tí mo ní kò dáhùn ni. Ta ló jókòó lórí ìtẹ́?
Who is sitting on the throne?
Yẹn ni kò dáhùn lórí ọkàn rẹ.
Ẹni
tó jókòó lórí ìtẹ́ ló sọ pé mo sọ gbogbo di ọ̀tún.
The person sitting on the throne said.
Torí Jésù ló jókòó lórí ìtẹ́.
Because Jesus.
Ohun gbogbo gbọdọ̀ jẹ́ ọ̀tún nínú ayé.
Therefore everything must be new in my life.
Say that. Ohun gbogbo gbọdọ̀ jẹ́ ọ̀tún nínú ayé.
Pronounce that. That everything must be new.
Ohun gbogbo gbọdọ̀ jẹ́ ọ̀tún nínú ayé.
Everything must be new in my life.
Torí ìwọ ló jókòó lórí ìtẹ́.
Because you are sitting on the throne.
Christy. Olúwa wa ni agbára.
Amen.
Ẹyin ma wa lọ́dún
ìpèyìn. Say amen to that.
Ẹ ṣàmì.
Let me just mention one or two things under that.
Ẹ jẹ́ kí n kọ fẹ́nu kan nǹkan méjì lábẹ́.
Causes brought sicknesses and diseases.
Ẹ̀gún ló mú àìsàn. Àìsàn wá.
And all the hardship we have because of God.
Àti gbogbo ìnira.
In other words, there was a negative statement from the mouth of God.
Tori pe ede to lodi ti enu
Olorun jade. Listen to me. There was a negative statement from the mouth of God.
Ede to lodi ti enu Olorun jade.
We begin to go the contrary.
Pe ohun gbogbo a ma se lodi.
You remember?
Aranti.
When Balak called Balaam.
Nigba ti Balak pe Balaam.
He said Balaam has authority to bless. He has authority to make things work the contrary or cause.
O nítorí pé Bálámù ó ní àṣẹ láti bùkún ni ó sì ní agbára láti mú
gbogbo ṣe lòdì. Anybody you bless will be blessed. Anybody
ẹni tó bá ti bùkún á di ẹni òfin ẹni tó bá ti gẹ́gùn fún á di ẹni òfìrè.
Come and make things work against Israel for me.
Ó pè é pé kó wá jẹ́ kí ohun gbogbo kó ṣe lòdì fún àwọn Israel fún òun.
Let things turn to evil for Israel.
Ó yí ohun gbogbo sí ibi.
Come and turn it.
Wá yí padà sí ibi.
And somebody is on the throne.
Ẹnìkan sì wà lórí ìtẹ́.
The person who is on the throne.
Ẹni tó wà lórí ìtẹ́.
Has not spoken. He has blessed Israel.
Ìbùkún ló ń ṣe ló ń bùkún àwọn ọmọ Israẹli.
The person on the throne had bled blessed
Israel.
And so somebody now say, curse Israel for me. Numbers 22. Verse 12. Numbers 22. Verse 12.
On sit down, on sit with pay. Emi hale say, I saw her, lot of say, you told you fi si mi le eno bi. Ba la ki si yi fun pe, emi be o. Ba mi lo si ibo miran. Lati bi ti wo le ri won.
Numbers 22, Monica Oka. 23 lo nka yen.
And God said to Balaam, you shall not go with them.
You shall not go with them.
You shall not curse the people.
Yes.
For they are blessed.
They are what?
Blessed.
They are what?
They are blessed.
And Tojo Kolori, the person on the throne,
sitting on the throne,
had blessed them. Somebody now say, curse them.
And they can answer, can we
get and when Balaam begin to do the job, and the people were forcing him to curse.
And when
he said, how can I curse whom God has blessed?
Only by when he might say, and when he
the person on the throne said, I made everything new. When the person on the throne was taking the blood to the altar,
and
God asked him, what do you want?
He
came out, God, from today, let there be peace. Let there be salvation. Let there be peace. This will not work contrary to them again. Let this come in peace. Peace. Honest. Blessings. Jesus received that. And when he received that, he came to the presence of the apostles and he declared positive. He declared blessing, not negative. Peace be unto you. Peace be unto you. Not the world, but for you. You will be in the world, but you will be at peace.
I give you
peace, not at the world peace.
After that, brother,
come and sit here. Watch. All enemy of that your statement will be put under the feet of your church. Your people you bless will tramp over the enemy under their feet. The church is the feet of the Christ on earth. Christ is the head. The church is the feet here.
So anywhere
you go, Christ is washing you to match negative statement.
It will
be under your feet. Anything evil will be under your feet.
The
person on the throne said, you are blessed. Peace be unto you. Peace be unto you. Everything will work new for you. Everything will work new for you. Who said that? Jesus said that. The king on the throne declared that. So this morning, anything contrary to your life,
you
rest on your feet. Jesus has said, peace. Evil under my feet. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. Peace. Nothing will work contrary to me. Nothing will work against me. Heavens are not against me. The person on the throne is not working against me. So whatever is working against me here, you be under my feet this morning. In the name of Jesus. 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 In Jesus' name we pray. Say amen to that. Say amen to that.
Amen.
In Revelation chapter 22, verses 1 and 2, let me talk about the second phase of it.
Because
in the city of agony here, we will come out of this place and we'll get to the city of
God. 22, verses 1 and 2.
Then he showed me the river.
Yes.
Whose waters give life?
The water does what?
Gives life.
Underline it. A river. The water gives life. The water give life. Now
if
you take you to Ephesians chapter 5, verse 26. Ephesians chapter 5, verse 26. Jesus will take people to himself after he has washed them in the river of water.
Read so that he might sanctify her.
Yes.
Having cleansed her by the washing of water with the word.
Cleansing by the washing of water by the word. Washing of water, that water that gives life is the word. The water that gives life is what? The word of God. The river that gives life is the word of God. Where the word of God is, there is life. And life will go into you. Life will go into you. Soak yourself into the word of God, you have life. Look at it properly. The water that gives life is what?
Omi ton fun ni iye ni o ni oro.
Eh? What is it?
Oro Olorun.
What is it?
Oro Olorun.
What is it? And when that word of God have a place in you,
ti oro Olorun yi ti raye ninu aye wa.
Oh. All evils will vanish in your life in Jesus.
Gogo ti ako ra ninu aye wa
loruko. You are reading it to verse 2. You are reading to verse 2. Yes.
Then he showed me the river whose water gives life.
Yes.
Sparkling like crystal.
Yes.
Flowing out from the throne of God
where
and of the Lamb.
The throne of God. That's why when the word of God is moving under the anointing, coming from the throne, it will enter. The rhema will enter. It will transform you. You will be satisfied.
From the throne.
Messages you hear under the anointing
will
bring life, transformation.
Wa.
That's why the Bible says, don't fail to gather together with people of God. Don't fail to gather.
And
don't fail to gather because it falls from the throne.
From the throne.
From the throne.
Let it be there.
Direct from the throne.
Let it be there.
Direct from the throne.
Let it be there.
You are reading. You are reading.
Through the middle of the broadway of the city.
Yes.
Also on either side of the river.
Yes.
Was the tree of life.
Yes.
With its 12 varieties of fruits.
Yes.
Yielding every month its fresh crop.
So when the word is coming from the throne, whatever it touches will bring life. And it will bring healing. In the city we are going to. That is the city we are going to. If you are blind here, you won't be blind in that city. No cause here to be talking, this is my child, this is my mother. No suffering there. If you are paralyzed here, you won't be paralyzed here. Those things will end with this war. It will end with this war. Just like your agony end on the cross. Just like the power of sin was broken on the cross. And sin cannot rule you again. The evils of this world will not follow you to the new city. So all you are passing through here today is temporary. Focus your eyes in the city of God. That is the city of satisfaction. Underline it. If God can be healing us today through the power of the Holy Ghost, do you think sickness will enter the city?
Huh?
If there can be miracles today, then we have been healed, we have been satisfied.
Sadness,
agony enter into the new city.
That's
why we tell you, believers, what you are passing through is momentary.
It's momentary.
It's momentary. When a student is in school, you have hardship. It's momentary. The moment you graduate, you forget all the suffering of the school.
You forget everything.
You forget everything. Focus on the city we are going.
We
focus on the city we are going. Some of you also passed through it. When we were in the secondary school, it was the days they were taking care of us very much in the boarding house.
We
didn't have
this
place, some of us were in the boarding house. And the moment we got to the final class,
it
is a decision between all of us who were in the final class. No riot because of food. Everybody, when you are coming, prepare at home. The school gives to you is not okay. Feed yourself.
No riot.
Suffer. Suffer head will end this year. This is the end of suffering.
So
let us endure the last suffering. We are going, you know, to have school at that time was a big certificate. So we all resolve. I was telling my people at home recently, I said, where do you put it? I said, my soap is in my room. I'm a senior man. So nobody should riot.
If
they slap you, keep quiet. Some of us will come and teach in this school. Result is very good. They will employ you in that school. That's what I'm saying. Look ahead. What you are passing through will soon be over. It will soon be over. Your present situation will become history. Even now, before you get to heaven, it will become history. I repeat, before you get to heaven, your present situation will become history. What
you are passing through will change to a testimony.
It will change to a testimony because you are blessed people. God has not cursed you. Anything contrary will vanish in your presence. The only person that can be against you is God. The only person that can be against you is God. And
it's
not against you. Say it out. Is God against you?
Is
God against you? Has God cursed you?
He's
not fighting you. Anybody who fights you is fighting God. Anything working against you is working against the purpose of God. And that thing will not stand. You will not stand. You are working against my maker. You are working against my defender. You are working against my redeemer. You are not working against me. And you will not stand. God give me life. And I have the life of Christ. Anything different from that must vanish in my life. God plans a new thing for me. And I'm a man for the new city. I'm created for the new city. I'm created for the new city. I'm a candidate of the new city. I'm a candidate of the new city. I'm born for new things. If anybody be in Christ, it's a new creation.
It's
a new creation. So you have a mandate to to vanish. You can't fight God.
Oh, the power Lord, ja.
You can't fight God.
Oh, to kufu oni na
kipale ara. God has spoken well concerning me.
Olorun ti soro ohun rere
nipa mi. God has spoken well concerning me.
Olorun ti soro ohun rere nipa mi.
New things are made for me.
Oh, tutun la ke
si fi la mi. And I'm made for the new city.
A si ti seto mi fun
ilu tutun. And I will go to the new city.
Ma si wo ilu tutun na.
You cannot disturb me from going to the new city.
Oh, de di mi lowo pe ki ma wo ilu tutun
ni. I'm a candidate for the city of God.
Omo ilu tutun Olorun ni mi.
I'm a candidate for the city of God.
Omo ilu tutun Olorun ni mi.
I'm a candidate for the city of God.
Omo ilu tutun Olorun ni mi.
I'm made for the city of God.
A ti pese mi sile fun ilu tutun ni.
In
Jesus' name,
I will be stopping there because of my time. I'll be talking of where to sing and who to sing.
Next time. But
just say it out. The troubles of this world will soon be over.
I will soon cross over. I will soon
cross over.
Help
me to stand.
Ran mi lowo lati le duro.
Help me not to lose focus.
Ran mi lowo ki ma se so aso afojusun mi nu.
Some perish in the wilderness and they didn't cross over.
Aimoye lo nse gbesi agiju won
koja
won ge koja odo.
Because of ordinary things.
Itori ohun ti o ni tumo.
But those who in the midst of difficulties were talking what God was saying.
Sugbon awon to ntenu mo oro Olorun ninu
peleja won. Caleb had my mind.
Gẹ́gẹ́ bí Ọlọ́run ṣe sọ
pé Caleb ẹni bí ọkàn mi ó ń sọ ọ̀rọ̀ mi
láàrin wàhálà ó tẹnu mọ́
ọ̀rọ̀
nígbà tí àwọn yòókù rí wàhálà tí wọ́n rí ìṣòro
ṣùgbọ́n
Caleb rí Ọlọ́run tó ga ju ìṣòro lọ wàhálà wà níbẹ̀ nítòótọ́.
God has blessed us.
Oni sugbon Olorun ti
God loves me.
Olorun fe mi.
God will take me to the place.
Olorun a mu mi debe.
Those Canaanites, they are our food.
Awon ara Kenani yen onje ojo je wa ni won.
Je
won ni wa.
Je
wa ni won.
A segun won.
We will overcome.
Awon lo ma bori.
We will overcome.
Ta lo ma bori.
Who will overcome?
Ta lo ma bori.
Who will overcome?
Oni ta lo ma bori.
Who will overcome?
Awon to ba ti ni eri yen lo ma wo ilu.
All those who have that testimony.
Awon lo ma bori.
To that city they will overcome.
So bi ma tan lojo kan o.
This place we
will. Se o bori.
Will you overcome?
Se iwo lo ma segun.
Will you overcome?
Se iwo lo ma segun.
Will you overcome?
Se iwo lo ma bori.
Will you overcome?
Awon yen lo ma wole.
Those are the people that will enter.
Ise awon to ngbon ni waju isoro pe.
Not those who are forgetting.
Se awon ma pa order ni, won ma pa order.
Yeah, they will kill them.
Iwo ni yo ja se baba yo ja fu won so be sa be
atwale boko boti lesu.
A new tomorrow.
Emi lo ma bori o.
I will overcome.
Ilu tutun ni mo nlo o. Ojo ayo na nbo, ojo ijosin nbo.
And that day of joy.
Ojo pe mi nbo.
The day of my praise is at hand.
Name
pe alaboko fun ni wa.
We are blessed.
Eto te se fun wa ni pe ka ma
ko. You have for us.
Ka ma yo ni waju
yin. Be rejoicing in your presence.
O ti tun le ti seto fun wa.
Plan a new thing for us.
Ilera otun oku otun. Agboruko yin ga Olorun.
Loruko
Jesu Kristi. Oluwa gba pe wa. Lori ile yi gan.
On this land.
Ka ti e to dele.
Before we go to heaven.
Bibeli so pe awa ta ti to ebu orun wo.
We that we have.
At o ta ma je lohun ye agbara je to bo lori ile yi pe a o ma je. O na na so na to la tun gbo lowuro yi. Loruko Jesu Oluwa gba ope wa.
God accept our thanks.
Ni oruko Jesu Oluwa gba ope wa. Ogo ni foruko yin
Olorun. Glory be to God.
Ba ti wa n lo ninu irin ajo.
As we are going in the journey of life.
Irin ajo ye o ti ko ti tan. A n lo ninu irin ajo.
The journey is not yet end.
Bi oko n ba wa kora jopo ni waju
wa. If anything has so shaped and
served in our presence.
Father, let them be stabilized.
Loruko Jesu Kristi ka ma tuka.
Father, be broken into pieces.
Baba ro oko n to lo n fe dide.
If you see anything that want to rise against us.
agbadura loruko Jesu.
We pray in the name of Jesus.
Tori pe aje alabuko.
Because we are blessed.
Loruko Jesu kan ma dayabule
ni wa. Let them be subdued themselves in their presence.
Ako mi pa ti wa wi pe.
It is written concerning all that.
A o pe ijumo.
We will trample upon the serpent.
A o ti akeke mole.
We will trample upon the scorpion.
A o ri lori gbogbo agbara ota.
We will trample upon the power of darkness. If you see any leader associated with
Jesus, I'm going to come
down. Upon them in the mighty name of Jesus.
Katoman, katon sele.
Before they know what happened,
I will know God.
Who hands into the glory?
I will know God.
Who hands into the glory?
I want God to walk glory.
They will congratulate us.
I want God to walk glory.
They will congratulate us. Glory be to God.
Jesus Christ.
Jesus Christ.
Olua wa.
Amen.
Jesus Christ. Olua wa.
Jesus Christ.
Ifeti Olorun.
God in heaven.
Ẹni tó gba aráyé là.
The person that saved the world.
Ẹni tó gbé abalè ní iyì.
So that we can be with him forever. Amen.
Bí ti beru se bi o ti wo ni wa je mu lo pa ile yi pada meji e ja ti joko jesu lo wa tun baba ko ma te nu mo ile awa ona to to la mo mi gba mi o ni to lo wi rara an ke ni re asa ju o fun mi a sha na mi ni re akore mata apade mi lona amo ore le wa ife dara dara ta pe se sile mo fa mara o ma te nu mo ile awa ti ti ba ja Ibada ye emi aru la o daju para ba ni aye ara o ni ni ti mo ma ye ni waju oluwa e kure ayo ati reni ibi o ni ba mi re ara mi fo ara re kire aye mi awa mi ri ara re ile ko mi a si o Okay, more for it. I'm not letting you know. Maybe you're dead. Oh, tell her love for our day. I'm not so tall of a woman that you only got out of me. I can't hear it. I saw you open me. I shall not be there. I'm for the matter. I can't hear it. I'm for everyone.
Oh,
Be the glory, honor, and adoration for this Sunday morning again.
If you go at your Latin, you fun ruko yin fun aro ojo isimi.
Thank you for feeding us.
Adupe fun eyin le bo wa.
Thank you for strengthening us.
E fun wa adupe fun okun te n fun.
Thank you for encouraging us.
Adupe pe en ru wa lokan soke.
Thank you for helping us to fix our eyes in heaven.
Adupe pe eyin le ran wa lowo lati gbe oju wa si.
Thank you for a time of crisis like this that you have been with us. Even though we walk in the valley of the shadow of death, you are with us. You are making us to pass through the storms of life. You have taught us, and we know that, like you are reminding us last Sunday, that we are going to work on our challenges. We are going to be on top of any difficulties. We are on top of all challenges. Just as you made Peter as a representative of the church to walk on waters, we too we shall walk on all challenges. This morning, encourage us, strengthen us, equip us, heal the sick, rescue the perishing.
Amen.
Rekindle our focus again.
Amen.
In Jesus' name we pray.
Amen.
God knows all about you. Your regret will end. Stop complaining. God knows all about you. Your regret will end.
Amen.
Point number 3 there this morning. Rest. Commit your case to him.
Simi kosi ko gbogbo oro re le lowo.
Your case is settled in heaven.
Ati yanju oro re lorun.
Your case is settled in heaven.
Ati yanju oro re lorun.
Because of that, rest or commit all you have unto him, unto Christ alone.
Itori eleyi gbowo ara re ko gbogbo ohun ti se ti re ko le lowo.
In our previous lectures under this topic, we said, if you stop complaining, your regret will end, because Christ has gone to the source of your troubles, the source of your sorrow.
Aniko shiwaru ye tori pe Jesu Christi o ti lo si orisun wahala ati orisun isoro re.
At the source, he has dealt with all that is disturbing us.
Gbogbo ohun to n yo wa lenu lo ti gbogun ti.
And your regret will be over.
Abamo re o si ti koja lo.
Last week,
lose to koja,
stop complaining.
Shiwo aruye,
he will wonderfully rescue you from the hand of the enemy.
Tori pe yo gba o lowo awon
ara. He's a God of warrior. And the enemy will never overcome you. He can never handle you to the enemy. He was going with them from nation to nation. And he has spoken, do my anointed no harm. Nobody will do you any harm. Nobody will harm you. He will restrain all that is against you. All those who gather against you, God will restrain them.
gbogbo awon to nse lodi si ololorun a si lowo ise.
You could remember when Abraham was going from journey to journey.
Aranti ba ti Abraham
Gera,
ninu irin ajo.
That is Genesis chapter 20.
Ninu iwe Genesis ori
oku. In Gera, the people there took his wife.
Ni Gera ni awon to wa nibe ti gba iyawo.
The king took his wife.
Oba ilu na gba iyawo.
In the night.
No.
God restrained the man.
Olorun da duro.
And God told the man, Abimelech the king of Gera, God told him.
Olorun so fun Abimelech oba Gera.
That you are a dead man.
Pe oku ni o.
That's another man's wife.
Iyawo elomiran lo gba
yi. That's another man's wife.
Iyawo elomiran ni.
You will die if you don't release the wife.
Wa ku to ba jowo iyawo.
And the man said, he told me it's his sister. I did it in the integrity of my heart.
Oba na wa da Olorun lohun oni o so fun mi pe arabinrin oun ni ko so fun mi pe iyawo oun ni.
God said, I know you are ignorant.
The language,
that was why I stopped you. I didn't allow you to touch the woman. God restrained the man. God will restrain the enemy on your behalf. God will restrain the enemy on your behalf. All that are trying to harass you, to molest you, God will restrain them in the name of Jesus.
So
rest.
See me.
Rest.
See me.
Commit whatever is disturbing you to the hand of the Lord Jesus Christ. Underline my language. Your case is already settled in heaven. That's what we are going to look at this morning. That's
Jeremiah.
Chapter 20. That's our text. Jeremiah chapter 20. Verse 12. I'm using the latter part of verse 12.
And
I'm using the message combined with New Living Translation.
I rest my case with you.
Underline it. I rest my case with you. Can you rest your case with God this morning? Rest your case with God this morning. All that is against you have been settled in heaven. Read it in Yoruba so that others can understand me.
Oluwa awon omo ogun.
Bẹẹni.
Iwo tin dan lododo wo. Iwo si ri inu ati okan. Emi o ri esan re lara won. Nitori ti mo ti fi oran mi le olowo.
Oh
Lord of heaven's armies, you test those who are righteous and you examine the deepest thoughts and secrets. Let me see your vengeance against them, for I have committed my cause to
I've
you.
I've handed over my case.
Mo ti fi oran mi le olowo.
Hand over. When you hand over, you relax. You do nothing about it. When you hand over, you do nothing about it. Because you cannot help yourself. It is only when you can help yourself, you will still be struggling. And when you run hitter skater, you can get to the trap of the enemy. People advise you to work on it. People will tell you to do something about it. Go out. And when you go out, you go to the hand of the enemy. The moment you go out, you go to the hand of Satan. Nobody stayed alone. Do something about it. Do something about it. Remember, this case, your own case, is settled already in heaven. There is a problem, the root of your problem. Jesus went to it. And what will not allow God to step into your case is settled before God in heaven. Because the source of man's trouble is sin.
Orisun wahala eniyan ni ese.
Is causes that came upon man as a result of sin.
Egun to wa sori eniyan.
There are good promises God has made for us.
Awon ileri rere wa ti Olorun ti se fun wa.
God has never changed his mind.
Olorun o si yi okan pada
lori. Underline my language. God has never changed his mind.
Olorun o yi okan pada lori
gbogbo ileri rere to se. It is man that has run away from the presence of God.
Eniyan lo sa kuro niwaju Olorun.
Christ has solved what has made us to be a runaway child.
Jesus si ti wa yanju ohun to so wa di sansa omo.
Thank you very much. So you can now come boldly to him.
Awa le wa pelu igboya si waju
le bayi. Present your case to him.
Kasi ko oro wa le lowo.
I repeat.
Bo tu so.
God has never changed his mind about you.
Mo ni Olorun o yi okan pada lori oro.
He's the same.
Bakan na lori.
For instance.
Fun apere.
When before man committed sin,
ki eniyan to dese,
he blessed man,
o bukun eniyan,
be fruitful,
kama
multiply.
So kasi ma gbile si.
When sin came,
nigba te se wole,
he cursed the ground,
o fi le re,
he cursed man,
o fi eniyan re.
You all remember all those ones.
Gbogbo wa la mo la ranti
yoku. And man began to run away,
eniyan wa nsakiri.
Man became a wanderer.
Until
the whole world committed abomination before God.
Everybody
compromised, and God destroyed the world with flood.
And
he remained Noah alone. When Noah came out, before God blessed Noah, God received a sweet smelling savor sacrifice before him.
And God
now declare after that sweet smelling
sabre
that I will no longer cause the ground because of man. As long as the world remains, there will be time of seasons of rain, seasons of planting, seasons of harvest. After that, man began to live in the world. There are troubles. God focused his eyes on the called, on the chosen. When Abraham returned home, God called him out of the world. God called him from Mesopotamia. He stopped him from being a wanderer. He had challenges. But because he has now come, he has become the chosen. He has become the call. God was focusing on him. God was dealing with him. You know, God didn't touch the challenge he had. He was dealing with Abraham.
Abraham
now surrendered. Abraham now handed over his case unto God totally.
He did
nothing about it again. When God discovered that he didn't do anything about it, there was a time he challenged God. He said in chapter 15, Genesis, you didn't give me a child. God said, I'm dealing with you.
That's my interpretation.
Take a red heifer, 3 years old. Take a lamb, 3 years old. Take a goat, 3 years old. And take turtle dove. Bring it to me. Don't cut the turtle dove and the pigeon. Don't cut them. Cut the heifer into two. Red heifer. Cut the 3 year lamb into two. Cut the goat into two. Be looking at it like this. Focus your eyes there. Just focus your eyes
there.
And Abraham was looking at it.
Abraham,
and don't touch those turtle dove. And those turtle dove were coming there. Abraham was driving there. God now discovered that Abraham was focusing on those slaughtered animals.
Olorun wa ri pe awon eran ti a ti la yi ni Abraham gbe oju re si.
God now forced him to sleep.
Olorun wa fi orun ejika.
And God told him.
Olorun wa so fun.
Can you count the sand?
Se o se se fun o lati ka
ipo ile. Can you count the sand in the sea?
Se o le ka ipo ile.
Can you count the stars in heaven?
Se o le ka irawo oju orun.
That's how your children will be.
Bi awon omo re a se ri ni.
Take note.
Kiyesi.
This your children.
Awon omo re wonyi.
This land is for you.
Ile yi iwo ni mo
fi. Because you are focusing, I've called you. This land is for you.
Tori pe mo ti pe o,
iwo ni mo fi. But I am not giving it to you now.
Sugbon mi o ti fun o bayi.
Your children will go to a land served there 400 years.
Awon omo re won lo si ile ajoji fun
iwo. And I will bring them back here. I will bring them back here. What am I bringing now? It is you God is looking at. God wants you to focus on the resurrection, the cross, the death of Christ.
Olorun fe ko gbo ko gboju si iku ati ajinde Jesu Christi.
That focus yourself on the cross. Focus yourself at the cross.
Sugbon ka gboju si abilebu.
You commit sin.
Aiba amon.
To put an end, the Lamb of God that has taken away the sins of the world is the 3-year-old lamb.
Odo agutan Olorun to ru ese aye lo
oni agbo lodun meta yi. Of evil in man that have been killed, that have been nailed to the cross, that is the ego.
In ewuri olodun meta yi ni iyen ni eda eniye
se to menu eniye. The work of sin. Focus yourself, focus your eyes on what I've done.
Pe mo du pari oro ise. Iwo se agboju se ohun ti mo ti se, yi mo ti se ni ko ma wo mo ti se.
Sin will no longer overcome me.
Ese oni bori mi.
Sin will no longer overcome me.
Ese oni bori mi.
Focus on it and be tender.
Iyen ni ko gboju si.
When I see you looking at Christ.
Ti mo ba kiri to gboju si Jesu
dara. Then you will walk, you will be over your challenges.
Wa gori wa ma rin lori gbogbo ipenija
re. You will say over all your challenges.
Wa rin lori gbogbo ipenija re.
What am I talking this morning?
Kila n so laaro.
Your case is already set.
Oni ati yanju oro wa.
Your case is already set.
Oro wa ti niyanju.
Just commit your case to Christ this
morning.
In Isaiah chapter 37 verse 14, let me take some few verses before I go to my key points.
And Ezekiah received the letter from the end of the messengers.
Yes, that's an example. Yes.
And Ezekiah went up to the house of the Lord.
Yes.
And spread it before the
Lord. You all remember Sennacherib wrote letters through the Rabsaken.
He wrote a letter
to harass
lati hale
that they would take over Jerusalem, they would take over
Judah.
When that evil letter came to the man of God
there,
that man of God took the evil letter and went to the temple and laid it
down
and read the letter. He read the letter. When you get to go and read chapter 37 of Isaiah, you
can see 2 Kings 19. Oba keji.
You can read that at
home. Time cannot allow me to go there.
When he read that letter, God came up and told him, don't worry yourself,
Ezekiel.
The battle is mine. That Sennacherib will never enter this town.
Sennacherib
will be killed in his own house. He will never enter this town. That forces harassing you will never enter your house. The language the devil is saying about you will never come to pass.
Amen.
Take that case into the house of prayer. Don't go to
anybody.
Don't complain to any human being.
Spread
it in prayers. Tell God this is what is happening. You all remember Anna. You all remember Anna. We won't read it in 1 Samuel chapter 1. And I have problems, he has challenges because he couldn't give birth to children. She was a waiting mother.
And
she didn't complain to any human being because no man can solve your case. And Anna came before God and wept.
Anna,
weep in the presence. Whatever weeping you want to weep, come and weep it. No pastor can solve your case.
You
remember, can Eli help him? He couldn't help him.
Even
when he was free, Eli thought she was drunk. Don't be rude to a man of God.
You
will lose your blessing. Don't be rude to them. You know, she could bluff the man when the man said, get up there, you drunken woman.
There are
occasions a man cannot understand you.
Ọpọlọpọ igba ni àwọn ìránṣẹ́ Ọlọ́run ṣe ṣe kí òye ọ̀rọ̀ rẹ má yé wọn. Wọ́n sì lè bá ọ wí torí pé òye ọ̀rọ̀ rẹ ò yé wọn.
Address them honorably and gently.
Ìwọ ni kò rọra fi tọ̀wọ̀tọ̀wọ̀ bá wọn sọ̀rọ̀.
When they pray for you, your prayer will be answered.
Tọ́ba sì ti gbàdúrà fún ọ, àdúrà àwọn
gbọ́dọ̀ wọ̀nyí. And Eli said, God will grant you your request.
Eli wa ni adura re Olorun a fi down.
Did God grant the woman the request?
Nje Olorun fi down
adura re. But if she has spoken rudely.
Sugbon to ba je pe o ti soro buburu si iranse Olorun yi nko.
Our way will be blocked.
Awa di ona re pa.
Your way will not be blocked in the name of Jesus. So don't be rude though. You are nothing. Without the man of God, you are nothing. Just a little digression. This is a personal thing.
By
on the Facebook yesterday,
lori igbe
alelujara let them call them my colleagues or people that are siblings of my father in the Lord, like myself. They posted the picture of my father. That is Reverend Michael Oye.
And if you want that picture,
everybody, they say Baba is now 81.
One name, Baba,
you know, Baba is still driving. He's still 81 and he's still driving. He's still preaching. He's as strong, very strong. I told you I visited him. They posted. So there I was moved. I started to rejoice and I had to write. I said, without you, I cannot be what I am today.
It was the first Sunday
of March 1973 that I entered his sitting room and he was exposing the Bible and the word of God moved me onto my knees and I surrender all. I surrender all. Unto him, my blessed Savior. I surrender. He has fathered many of us. He has fathered.
He's
the father of evangelicals in Nigeria.
He made us.
And everybody today rejoices. And if he goes home, we will all be happy that he has gone home. But he's still alive. Don't be rude to them. According to Paul, I am what I am by what? By the grace of God.
But
God used somebody for him. So God used people for you. You are here because somebody accepted
you.
Respect them. Pray for them. Follow them. Don't be rude to them. That's the digression.
Anna,
rest your case to God. Rest your case to God. You know what the Bible talks about men of God in Hebrews chapter 13? Both verse 7 and verse 17. He said, they are watching over you.
Let them do it with joy.
If you are
sorrowful, it won't hurt.
If
they should be worshiping God with sorrow, it won't help. Let them do it with joy. It will be well with us. It will be well with us.
Let me now quickly take some few points. What is the problem? What case did you have before God in heaven? What the problem that is standing against you before God? Three things are working against us. Number one, our sin is in the presence of God. The Bible, Psalm 90, verse 8-9. Psalm 90, underline it. If that sin in his presence is not removed, your way will be blocked. Quickly read, I'm listening. Yes.
Oh, ikoko wan be ninu imole iwaju re.
Otito so nyibo e.
Our iniquities, our secret acts, and its sins, which we would so like to cancel even from ourselves, you have said in the revealing light of your countenance.
Everything is in the presence of God. God is looking at it every day. And no prayer can be answered as long as your sin is in the presence of God. So sin is working against us. It's in the presence of God. Number two, that is working against us. Blood is speaking. Blood is speaking. Blood can speak two things. Blood can work against us. Blood can work in our favor. Genesis chapter 4.
Genesis chapter 4.
Verse 10.
Verse 1.
Yes.
Kini washeni. Oh, my jarakun rin ren kigbe pe mi lati nu ile wa.
Those whom you have slaughtered with your mouth.
àwọn tó ti fẹnu jàmbá.
You are bitter against.
Tó ti ní ìkórè
ọkàn sí. Those whom you have made to fall one way or the other.
Àwọn tó ti
through talkativeness, through backbiting, through evil acts, and your actions or your inactions sometimes has slaughtered some people. Their blood will be crying in the presence of God.
Àwọn ènìyàn tó ti pa nípa ọ̀rọ̀ ẹ̀yìn nípa ọ̀rọ̀ ìsọkúsọ tó ti sọ ẹ̀jẹ̀ wọn ń ké níwájú Ọlọ́run.
Those whom you have spoken against and some through your words they can even commit suicide.
Àwọn ènìyàn tó ti sọ̀rọ̀ búburú sí tó jẹ́ pé tẹ́lòmí ò bá rò dáadáa
ni ó lè kókò sótorí ọ̀rọ̀ tó ti sọ. So many abortions committed. So many evils committed.
Àwọn ibi tó ti ṣe.
The blood is talking in the presence of God.
Ẹ̀jẹ̀ ń sọ̀rọ̀ níwájú Ọlọ́run.
And that blood is working against human beings.
Ẹ̀jẹ̀ yìí sì ń ṣe ó ń ṣe
lòdì
sí ènìyàn.
Second Kings.
Àwọn ọba kejì.
Chapter 9.
Orí kẹsàn-án.
And verse 16.
Ẹsẹ̀ yìí. As surely as I saw yesterday, the blood of Naboth and the blood of his sons, says the Lord, I will repay you on this plot of ground.
Can you see Ahab covetousness through his covetousness took the property of another person and he killed him.
Nípasẹ̀ ojú kòkòrò Ahabu ó gba ilẹ̀ ní
arákùnrin kan ó sì pa. Sometimes he took other people's property and because of that they have hypertension and they die suddenly.
Lọ́pọ̀lọpọ̀ ìgbà bóyá gba ohun ìní tó jẹ́ ti ẹnìkan tìtorí eléyìí ń wá ní ẹ̀jẹ̀ rúru.
Your wicked ass can make people to have diseases that will lead to their untimely death.
Ìwà búburú wa nígbà mìíràn ó lè mú kí ẹlòmíì kó
dìde àìsàn
kó sì jẹ́ àìsàn yìí lápá.
Your behavior to your husband.
Ìwà sí ilẹ̀ sí ọkọ rẹ sí
àyà rẹ. Your behavior to your boss.
Ìwà rẹ
sí ilẹ̀ sí ọgbà rẹ. Even your behavior to members of the congregation and your unit.
Ìwà sí ilẹ̀ gan sí àwọn ará ìjọ àbí ní ìkórè.
Can make them to misbehave and have diseases that will lead to their untimely death.
Ìwà rẹ ló ti jẹ́ kí ẹlòmíràn kó dìde àìsàn.
Covetousness and so many other behaviors can lead to that.
Ìwàkiwà lóríṣiríṣi ó lè fa
eléyìí. So our actions are causing evil to other people.
Ìhùwàsí wa nígbà míì ó ń fa ibi bá ẹlòmíràn.
No, you know what Cain said? What concerns me? Am I his policeman?
Mo ti Káínì sọ, ó ní kí ló kàn mí? Ṣé èmi ni olùṣọ́ rẹ ni?
When that person collapses or dies, the blood will be crying.
Tí irú ẹni bẹ́ẹ̀ bá wá ṣubú lulẹ̀ tó bá kú.
Some of you rejoice when somebody dies.
Ọ̀pọ̀lọpọ̀.
Who has done something against you, he dies, you rejoice.
Bóyá ẹnìkan ti ìwà tí ò dáa sí wa tó bá wá kú inú wa máa dùn.
His blood will be shouting in the presence of God.
Torí pé èrò ibi náà lakúkú ń rò sí tẹ́lẹ̀ tí irú ẹni bẹ́ẹ̀ bá wá kú ẹ̀jẹ̀ rẹ̀ a máa
ṣe lòdì sí wa.
Ẹ̀jẹ̀ wà
nínú olúwa. The blood of Naboth was shouting.
Ẹ̀jẹ̀ Naboth ó ń ké níwájú olúwa.
And God has to repay it. God has to repay it.
Ọlọ́run ní láti san.
Those are the things working against us.
Àwọn tó ń ṣe lòdì sí wa
nìyí. So mind your words.
Ẹ kíyèsí ọ̀rọ̀
yìí. Mind your behaviors.
Ẹ kíyèsí
ìwà yìí. And there is nobody that is free from this.
Kò sì sí ẹni tó lè sọ pé òun yọ̀ǹda òun gbòmìnira nínú gbogbo eléyìí.
You know some people say, I didn't do evil. I've never killed anybody.
Ẹ mọ ọ̀pọ̀lọpọ̀ a máa sọ pé a ṣe bí.
Look at the actions you have made that has made some people to be hypertensive. And hypertension is a great killer. It's a great killer.
Ìwọ náà wo àwọn ìgbésẹ̀ wo àwọn ìwà tó ti hù sí àwọn kan tó ti jẹ́ kó ní ẹ̀jẹ̀ rúru ó sì ń pànìyàn.
When hypertension will come when somebody have sleepless nights.
Tí ènìyàn ò bá ti lè sùn lóru.
When you cause problem that give people headache, sleepless nights, it will lead to hypertension and if he dies, the blood will be speaking again.
Nígbà tí ìhùwàsí rẹ tó bá ti sọ ẹnìkan di aláìlè ìróorunsùn tí àìróorunsùn yìí tó sì wá mú ẹ̀jẹ̀ rúru wá.
It happens very much in the family. Family problems lead so many men to have sleepless nights.
Wàhálà ẹbí lọ́pọ̀lọpọ̀ ìgbà ó ń jẹ́ kí àwọn ọkùnrin mìíràn kán má lè sùn.
Behavior of children causes sleepless nights for fathers.
Ìhùwàsí àwọn ọmọ nígbà mìíràn kì í jẹ́ kí bàbá wọn kó rọrùn sùn.
Sometimes the mother will collaborate with the children and they will behave. Some men won't talk. Some men are so quiet they don't talk but they won't sleep.
Ìgbà mìíràn ìyá àtọmọ wọn fọwọ́sowọ́pọ̀ lòdì sí bàbá. Bàbá ò ní lè sùn bó tilẹ̀ jẹ́ pé ó lè má sọ̀rọ̀ nígbà mìíràn ṣùgbọ́n kò ní lè sùn.
There are some of us that are introverts, we talk. But some
will. Ọ̀pọ̀lọpọ̀ wa sọ̀rọ̀ sọ bó tò ní wá.
Those of us who talk when we are disturbed personally I won't sleep.
Tá gẹ́gẹ́ bí èmi báyìí tábà ti dí mi lọ́wọ́ mi ò ní lè rórun sùn.
And when you don't sleep.
Tó o bá sì ti sùn.
Your blood will shoot up.
Ìfúnpá ga sókè.
And if it's not controlled.
Tá a bá sì bójú tó.
It will affect your pancreas.
It will affect, and when your pancreas is affected, you will be going to toilet regularly urinating, and that pancreas affected will lead to diabetes mellitus. If it affects your kidney, then you have renal problem. Are you listening to me?
Ama to lori kore asi
a yo ri sin kan mi ninu agba ara
ti kidney na ba si yo nu
ala ni are so sensitive and the blood will be pumping as you shouldn't pump, and the moment your some of your arteries are and blood is flowing too much in your artery at a time, then you have you become hypertensive.
Okan wa wa ma sise odi a ma sise agbara eje a ma tu eje sita bi o ti ye ko tu sita awon bi ti eje ngba ko ja wa gba a wa ni wahala.
And before you know it, you have stroke and you die.
Ka to mo to nsele.
What killed that man? That man.
Romo la ro iro iro pade iro se ade.
He died like that. His blood will be talking.
Ti ru eni be to ba wa ku to si je iwo lo sokun fa re eje re a ma soro.
Blood is talking.
Again, sorrow.
As much as possible, live in peace with all men. But you can't do that as a man. Number three, the avenger of blood is around.
It's
always around. The avenger of blood is always around. And he will be pursuing you. He will be pursuing you. He will make the world to be difficult for you to live. The avenger is always around. Those are the things working against us. But I'm happy to announce to you today. Let me just take a verse for you to understand that. The avenger of blood is always around.
I don't want to watch.
Revelation chapter 6. Yes. Revelation 6, 10.
Won ki bele ohun rara wipe.
Eh?
Won ki bele ohun rara wipe.
Yes.
Yo ti pa to Oluwa. Eni ami ororo ati olooto. Eni mimo ati olooto. Iwa ki yo se idajo ki o si gbesan eje wa mo lara awon tin gbe ori ile aye.
Those people
write in a loud voice, O sovereign Lord, holy and true, how long now before you will sit in judgment and avenge your blood upon those who dwell on the earth?
Thank you very much. Those people are died.
I'm waiting on you.
And they are in heaven.
Won wa lorun.
And their blood is shouting,
God,
would you avenge our blood?
On
those on earth,
people on earth
led to our death.
Avenge.
And when God rises up, he will send the avenger of blood. And they begin to avenge blood. So this morning, I'm announcing to you, nobody is free from that except until Christ solved that problem. As believers, those of you are believers, watch out for all the things I've spoken this morning, so that you don't allow the avenger to go against you. But the good news is this: that case is settled before God. You are now free. Are you listening to me? Let me read the Bible before we go. Point number three. Sin does it, and cannot have a chance to compete with the aggressive grace of God. Underline that language. Sin didn't, cannot compete
with the aggressive grace of God.
Underline that language. Kò sí bí ẹ̀ṣẹ̀ ṣe lè dojú ìjà kọ. Jẹ́ kí mi ka Bíbélì
sí ojú jáde. Cannot wait for
Romans chapter 5 verse 20.
Ṣùgbọ́n òfin bá sí inú rẹ̀.
You read it in the message. Romans 5:20.
Ṣùgbọ́n òfin bá sí inú rẹ̀.
Bẹ́ẹ̀ni.
Kí ẹ̀ṣẹ̀ lè di púpọ̀.
Bẹ́ẹ̀ni.
Ṣùgbọ́n níbi tí ẹ̀ṣẹ̀ di púpọ̀.
Bẹ́ẹ̀ni.
Oore ọ̀fẹ́ di púpọ̀ rí kọjá.
The message will bring me out.
But sin didn't
and doesn't have a chance in competition with the aggressive forgiveness we call grace.
The aggressive grace. The aggressive forgiving grace of God. No matter what sin, no matter your sin, no matter the level of your wickedness, no matter the level of evil you have done, it didn't. It cannot. And it would not compete with the way God's favor, God's grace manifested to clearly. So whatever you have done, the grace of God will cover it
all.
The power of the grace of God will raise all sins before
you.
In verse 8 and 9, Amplified Bible Translation, verses 8 and 9 of Romans chapter 5. Yes.
But God shows and clearly proves His own love for us by the fact that while we were still sinners, Christ the Messiah, the anointed one, died for us.
You see all the evil we have committed, even before you know it, God has settled the case. That's my announcement. God has settled the case. That case that is in the presence of God, the aggressive grace of God through Jesus has solved it.
Gogo ejo to wa niwaju Olorun yi ore ofe Jesu Kristi ore ofe Olorun to re kaja o ti yanju re.
He paid what he did not owe.
Tori pe o san gbese ti o je.
He was not a sinner.
Ise elese.
He didn't have any sin on his own.
Ko ni ese
kese. He didn't commit any sin.
Ko da ese
kese. But he paid it all.
O san gbogbo re.
You will see that in Psalm 69 verse 4.
That
he said, I paid what I did not owe. And without the shedding of blood, there is no remission of sins. So, I'm going to my last point. I will quickly bring it out. That the blood of Christ has made our redemption final. One. Our redemption, take note, is final. Final. We were purchased. 1 Corinthians 7:23.
Thank you.
We were purchased with a price. And that price is the blood of Jesus. In 1 Peter chapter 1, we won't be reading everything, you all know it, is that it is not the blood of bulls. It's not the blood of goats. You can even read it. That we were bought from our evil actions, our evil behaviors, our corrupt nature, but the blood of Jesus, the sinless blood of Jesus. That blood has come to the presence of God. That blood is already in the mercy seat.
That is,
Kerubim, two Kerubim are there spreading their hands
under
the ark of the covenant, where another blood is now speaking. A blood is speaking against you. But a greater blood is at the majesty speaking.
Speaking mercy.
You won't be judged. You won't be condemned. You won't be judged. You are free from condemnation. You are free from condemnation. You are free from the avenger of blood. You are free from sin. The blood is in the mercy seat. Speaking at the mercy seat. Two cherubim are there. Two cherubim are there, spreading their hand there in the presence of God. And when God is looking, instead of seeing your sin today,
he sees
the blood of Jesus. Your sin is no longer in the presence of God. God will not reckon sin against you again. If only you can come to God. If only you can embrace the blood of Jesus. In Romans chapter 9, verse 14 through 16. Romans. Yes.
Asododo wa ha lodo Olorun bi.
Yes.
Ki a ma ri.
Yes.
Nitori o wi fun Mose pe
emi o sanu fun eni ti emi o sanu fun.
Yes.
Emi o se iyonu fun eni ti emi o se iyonu fun.
Nobody can restrain God. Take it in English.
Eni kan yo le
down. Nobody. That's verse 15. I need verse 15.
For he says to Moses, I will have mercy on whom I will have mercy.
I will have mercy. I will show mercy.
Ma sha anu fun.
Go. You have no case to answer, and nobody can restrain
it.
Jesus now declares, if anybody listen to my words and believe the person that has sent me, I give him eternal life. He will never come into judgment. He will never come into condemnation. He has passed from death to life. Instead of the sword of the avenger, he has passed to life. I will no longer send him to hell. I will judge him. I will judge him. I'm asking him to go freely. The woman in Romans, in John chapter 8, who was taken in adultery, everybody, the avenger of blood, people want to avenge and stone has to death. We are doomed to die. We are doomed to perish. We are doomed to perish. Nobody is qualified to live.
Then
the blood of Jesus is speaking mercy.
That
if you call on Jesus today, that blood will set you free completely. That blood will set you free completely. And this is the day of mercy. Where the blood is today, in Psalm 102, verse 13, God will rise up and show you mercy today. How many of you want the mercy of God today? In verse 13, you can read that. I want you to confess that in prayer. It is your day. It is your day. Yes, you will arise
and have mercy
and have mercy
and loving kindness for Zion.
Yes.
For it is time to have pity and compassion for us.
Take it in Yoruba. It is the time for you to have compassion and mercy on me.
Yes, the moment designated has come.
The time has come. The moment has come. The moment has come. Say it out. The moment has come. The moment has come. The time has come. This is the acceptable time. The blood of Jesus is on the altar. Rise on your feet. This is my time. You will rise up and show mercy unto me. You will rise up and show mercy unto me. This is my time. This is my time. Show mercy on me today. You will rise up and show kindness on me today. I don't want you to judge me because of my sin. I'm holding to the blood of Jesus. I'm holding to the blood of Jesus. I'm holding to the blood of Jesus. Today you will rise up and show mercy. Today you will rise up and show mercy unto me. Because I cannot help myself. Jesus, you pay the price. Jesus, you pay the price. Jesus, you pay the price. We pray. In Jesus' name we pray. You know, in our song, holy, 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 Lord God Almighty, early in the morning the sun shall rise. Holy, 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 merciful and mighty, the God in three persons and the Trinity.
Father,
He was, he is, and he shall be forever.
Otiwa.
Those cherubim are there, and the blood is there, worshiping God there. And there, Lord Jesus Christ entered into that throne and poured his blood.
And when
God saw the blood, evil will overpass you. That blood has once and for all settled your cases. So the issue of sin is solved once and for all. We were in my family altar this morning. I said, look, our family, our redemption, salvation is total, final, and comprehensive.
In my family
altar.
Total, final,
fully comprehensive. You know what led me to it? God came to Abraham.
Olorun to Abraham wa.
That I want to destroy Sodom.
Pe mo fe pa Sodom run.
Forget about his pleading, he pleaded, he did everything.
E gbagbe ni gba pe o Olorun soro.
Two angels of destruction enter Sodom. All to take note. They came to observe whether what the noise they are hearing is correct.
Ki angeli apaninu to wo Sodom Olorun ran awon iranse re lati wa wo
ibe get the message. The two angels that came angeli to destroy Sodom
lati pa Sodom
only came from heaven
won wa latorun
to observe
lati kiyesi
whether the noise they were hearing about Sodom is correct.
Boya ibe ti won gbo latorun wa boya otito ni.
They have had the smell of sin.
We have come
to see whether it's true.
Awa lati wa si lati wa wo boya looto ni nkan ta
nbo. See that in Genesis chapter 18.
Iye wa nu iwe Genesis ori kejidinlogun.
But when you go to Genesis chapter 19.
Ni Genesis ori kokandinlogun.
Those angels enter Sodom.
Awon angeli won de Sodom.
When they get to Sodom.
Nigba ti won de be.
They were going to the street square to sleep. They came in the evening and they went to the street square. But Lot recognize them. He pleaded with them to come to his house. They said, no, we are sleeping outside. After much pleading, those angels enter his house. He prepared food for them. Forget about that. That's not my point this morning. Before you know it, the whole city came to that house. All men. Young and old.
That's 19 verse 4.
From every quarter, they came to
access
with those two men that are fighting.
No man has ever
known them. I branch a little bit. The issue of gay, lesbianism, what you call transgender. Number four, I think there are four, twins, or there are four. LS, and they call it their name. You know those four? That's where the world is going. That's
why
the world is going. I was reading in one of my daily readings I was reading yesterday,
the third largest
Pentecostal Evangelical Church, United Methodist Church in America,
are
splitted into two because of gay marriage. It was then the strongest church that oppose gay lesbianism in America.
Ijo yi kan na o ni ijo to to duro daada to talko wi pe okunrin fi okunrin
obinrin fi okunrin in America. Evangelical and Pentecostal as we are today.
Ba se ri loni lohun na ri nigba na lohun.
But now, recently, this
year,
there is a fight in the church. Among the leaders and everybody in the
church, no,
it's human rights. Men should marry men. Women should marry women. A man can turn himself to be a girl. A woman can make himself a man. And we shouldn't disallow them. We should allow people that are gay to be our pastor. We should allow gay women to sing in the choir. We shouldn't disturb them. This human right. They are all going to heaven.
So,
the church is splitting now. That's where the world is going. And that's where the world is going. The issue of gay. The issue of sodomy. The issue of sodomy. The issue of a man having sex with an animal. The issue of a woman having sex with a dog. The issue of men and women marrying animals. That's where the word is going. That's where the word is going. That's where the word is going.
So,
if anybody thinks that it stands, let him take heed, lest he does what? If anybody is thinking that he's standing, let him take heed, lest he falls. So, they enter Sodom. And when they got to Sodom, Lot, what do you have here? Comprehensive salvation. Take your wife. Take your two daughters. Go out now. Go and preach to the boys who wants to marry your daughter. Can you see the comprehensive salvation? Can you see the total salvation? Those boys proposing to marry those two girls are sodomites. They were unbelievers.
We
won't do anything until you bring those people out. Bring them out. And they were waiting for them. Comprehensive salvation. Don't go with your family. Oh, God is interested in all your children. Because you are saved. It's total.
The angels
was waiting for Lot. Lot preached to them. They said, it's one of those things.
Lot,
carry your guests.
We
don't need your guests. We are okay. And when that happens, the angel said, Lot, the Bible says Lot himself was still lingering. He had properties he was a rich man. Nobody can just take you out of your house. When they say you come out of your house, you want to
be Lot.
You don't need anything. If they say you should go to heaven today, you don't need anything. What will you take? And God now said, they lay hold upon his hand, pull the hand of the wife, pull the hand of his two children, and led them out of the city. Run for your dear life. Don't look back. Comprehensive salvation. I don't know. Jesus warned us we should be careful. I don't know. The Bible says, remember Lot's wife. The message is for us. Remember what? But take note, the one who saved is total. So when I'm declaring, your case is settled in heaven. My salvation is total. My salvation is total. Sin cannot stand against me before God.
You
better say it out. Sin cannot stand before me before God. Sin cannot. Sin did not. Sin cannot stand against the aggressive grace of God.
Kole duro niwaju ori ofe Olorun to lagbara.
Grace of God has saved me and saved by grace. Sin can never stand against me again. And the avenger of blood will never defeat me again. Because Jesus is at the right hand of God. And blood, the blood of God is talking mercy today. Today is the day of mercy. My account is balanced. My account is balanced. My account is total balanced. Totally balanced. In Jesus' name we pray. Before I end this lecture, I will say this, that Hebrews chapter 10, verse 14 to 18. Hebrews 10, 14 to 18.
Nítorí nípa ẹbọ kan ó ti mú àwọn tí a sọ di mímọ́ pé títí láé ẹ̀mí mọ́ sì ń jẹ́rìí fún wa pẹ̀lú.
Mo di gbígbé.
Àánú ń ba sáńjẹ́ tèmi nípa ẹbọ kan. Nípa ẹbọ kan. Nípa ẹbọ kan. Mo dájọ́ ìwọ́gbọ́. Mo rí pípé àánú bá bàjẹ́ tèmi nípa ẹbọ kan.
For by a single offering he has forever completely cleansed.
Underline it. Forever. Completely cleansed.
And perfected those who are consecrated.
Make us perfect.
And made us.
And what, why were we able, or why did we achieve this? How did we achieve this? In verse 16.
Eyi ni majamu
ti new covenant. Yes.
Èyí ni májẹ̀mú tí èmi ò bá wọn dá lẹ́yìn ọjọ́ wọn nílé Olúwa wí. Èmi ò fi òfin mi sí wọn lé ọkàn. Inú wọn pẹ̀lú lè mi ò sì kọ wọn sí ẹsẹ̀ wọn.
This is the agreement, testament, covenant that I will set up and conclude with them after those days, says the Lord. I will imprint my laws upon their hearts and I will scribe them on their minds.
Otito, when you come to the church, you hear the word, the word of God will be written in the tables of your heart. That's why you hear the word of God. Confess it. What you believe, you will confess. What you know, you will confess. And it will be in your heart. And when you confess what Jesus has done, God will uphold it. And to God, I have never seen anything there.
See, Olorun ko ri ese kankan nibe.
It's as if you have never committed.
Bien ni pe adese kankan ri.
You have never committed.
Adese kankan ri.
And Jesus, now the high priest, is sitting at the right hand. Go there.
Olufisun ko olufisun o le lo
sibe. No accuser can go there.
Olufisun olufisun kankan o le lo sibe.
God will never listen to the accuser.
Olorun o ni tati si awon olufisun.
God did not listen to Balaam and Balak. Whatever the enemy say about you, God will not listen.
Gẹ́gẹ́ bí Ọlọ́run ò ní tẹ́tí sí Bálámù àti
Bálákì. God will not listen.
Ọlọ́run ò ní tẹ́tí sí àwọn
kálórí ọ̀rọ̀ ẹ̀ mọ́. In conclusion this morning, I'm going back to where I started.
Ibi tí mo ti bẹ̀rẹ̀ náà ni mo fẹ́ parí
rẹ̀ sí. Press your case to God.
Dọ̀wọ́ gbogbo rẹ̀ fún Ọlọ́run.
What's troubling you this morning? Is there any letter the enemy has written to you?
Kí ló ń yọ ọ́ lẹ́nu báyìí láàárọ̀
yìí? Is there anything disturbing your mind?
Ìwé kíwé kan sí ọ, ohunkóhun yọ ọ́ lẹ́nu, yọ ọkàn rẹ lẹ́nu bí?
King Hezekiah went to the presence of
God. Ọba Hezekiah lọ síwájú Ọlọ́run.
And he knelt down.
Okunle.
And he talked to God.
Ó bá Ọlọ́run sọ̀rọ̀.
And God listened.
Ọlọ́run sì tẹ́tí.
He told him, God, you are the one that is sitting within the kerubim in heaven.
Ìwọ Ọlọ́run ló jókòó láàrín àwọn
kerubim. See what people are talking about me.
Ohun tí àwọn ènìyàn
sọ nípa mi. See the world that is facing me.
Sí ohun tí mò ń dojúkọ.
And God looked down from heaven.
Ọlọ́run bojú wọlẹ̀
láti. Today now we have the blood of Jesus. Then he didn't have the blood of Jesus there.
Lónìí a ní ẹ̀jẹ̀ Jésù.
They only have the blood of Jesus there. And God was able to hear Hezekiah.
Ẹ̀jẹ̀ gbọ́rọ̀ màlúù nìkan ló wà níbẹ̀. Ọlọ́run sì tẹ́tí sí
Hezekiah. And God listened to him.
Ọlọ́run gbọ́ ìgbé
rẹ̀. Today you are perfect.
Lónìí àpé.
Today you are made whole.
Lóni aso wa di.
Today no blood can speak against you.
Osi eje kan to le soro lo.
Today no accuser can stand before God.
Osi olufisun kan to le do niwaju Olorun lori oro
wa. Looking at you to show mercy to you.
Olorun wo wa lati sa.
Today is the day of your mercy.
Eni ni ojo anu temi.
Today is the day of your favor.
Eni ni ojo ojurere mi.
Today God will rise up and bear you out.
Lóni Olorun a so kale lati gba mi.
Can you say Jesus, I have come to you this day?
Ye a le so pe Oluwa mo ti wa loni.
Anybody can listen to your prayer, it doesn't matter.
Je keni ke ni ma tati sadura to ba
ko they will come and rejoice with you.
Sugbon won bo lati wa ba mi o.
They will come and rejoice with you.
Won bo lati wa ba oyo.
Go to God this morning.
E je ka lo siwaju Oluwa laaro.
Speak to God what is disturbing you.
E je ka ba Olorun soro lori ohun to
nju. I know the blood is there for me.
I have come
to you. I have come to you.
Mo ti wa siwaju.
Let us pray in the name of Jesus.
E je ka gbadura loruko Jesu.
Somebody help Anna to pray. Somebody help
Ezekiah
to pray. Nobody help Jabez to pray. Jabez knew what was disturbing him in the family. Nobody help Abraham to pray to God. You are the one that is going to pray to God and talk to God. But I'm only happy to announce that God is no longer fighting you. I'm happy to tell you that the blood of Jesus is speaking mercy this morning. Expose your mind to the God of heaven this morning. God will listen to you. Tell him what you want. Tell him your worries. Tell him your anxieties. Tell him your problems. Tell him what is disturbing you. Talk to him in just about 2 minutes. And the Lord will step in and take over your case. Àwọn ènìyàn ń gba ire tí wọ́n.
Some people are receiving their
movements. Wọ́n fẹ́ nu wọn jẹ́wọ́.
They are using their mouth to converse.
Ìwọ náà jẹ́wọ́ nǹkan tó
gbàgbọ́. You converse what you believe.
Gba ire tí ìwọ náà
ni wọ́n ti Olúwa. Receive your goodness from the Lord.
Sọ fún ọkàn ẹ náà pé kó sinmi.
Rest.
Kó sinmi àníyàn.
Rest
of anxious. Kó sinmi wàhálà.
Rest of.
Jesus Christ ti yanjú ẹ bọ́kan
lójú tí ó fún ìwọ àti ìwọ̀n.
Jesus Christ Olúwa wa. Bàbá mo ṣe la dúpẹ́ lọ́wọ́ yẹn. A gbé orúkọ yín ga.
We exalt your name.
Torí nǹkan tẹ́ ẹ tún ń bá wa sọ lówùrọ̀
yìí. For what you have been teaching us this morning.
Pé káyé ṣe wàhálà.
That we should be rest.
Pé káyé ṣe àníyàn.
But we should stop being anxious.
Pé ká gbójú sókè ká wo Kristi lórí
ìdí àgbélébó. We should lift up our eyes unto you on the cross.
Orísun ìwẹ̀ nù mọ́ ní fún ẹ̀mí kọ̀ọ̀kan wa.
Some sanctification for our soul.
A dúpẹ́ lọ́wọ́ yín bàbá mímọ́.
We thank you.
Lórúkọ Jésù Kristì, Olúwàgbà ọ̀pẹ wa.
Father, Lord, accept our thanks.
Lórúkọ Jésù, Olúwàgbà ẹ̀yìn wa.
Father, Lord, accept our praise.
Pé níwọ̀n ìgbà tá a ti gba Jésù Kristì.
Once we receive this Christ.
A ti wọ ìlú ààbò.
We have entered the refuge city.
Níbi tí agbẹ̀sẹ̀ ẹ̀jẹ̀ yìí
dé. Where the avengers of blood us
pray. Pé ìwọ Ọlọ́run ti yọwọ́ agbẹ̀sẹ̀ ẹ̀jẹ̀ kúrò lórí ọ̀rọ̀ ayé wa.
You have given us the avengers of blood from our lives.
A dúpẹ́ lọ́wọ́ yín Ọlọ́run wa.
We thank you, O Lord.
Ìwọ Ọlọ́run ṣe fún wa.
What you did for us.
Nínú ẹbọ tí Kristi
yóò fún wa. In the savour of Christ.
O yọwọ́ ẹsẹ̀.
You removed
the blood of
sin. You removed the blood of
curse
from our lives.
O wa sọ wá di òmìnira.
It make us free.
Lórúkọ Jésù Kristì, Olúwàgbà ọ̀pẹ wa o.
Father, Lord, accept our thanks.
Ní orúkọ Jésù, Olúwàgbà ẹ̀yìn wa o.
Father, accept our praise.
Bàbá mi máa wá ń gbàdúrà.
Father, we pray.
Ẹ̀kọ́ yìí.
This sermon.
Kí ìwọ Ọlọ́run kó ràn wá lọ́wọ́ ká fi tí ojú sí.
So that we can put it into the.
Nígbà tí ìpènijà bá ń dé.
When the challenges come.
Nígbà tí àwọn ẹ̀mí yẹn tó bá ń sọ kẹ́lẹ́kẹ́lẹ́ sínú ọkàn wa.
Whispering into our hearts.
Wípé àmàní wàhálà.
That we have many predicaments.
Bí àmàtí jogún ẹsẹ.
We have heard the same.
Kí ẹ̀kọ́ yìí kó ràn wá létí
wípé. So that this will remind us that.
Nípa ẹbọ kan soso.
Through one servo.
Nípa ẹbọ kan soso.
Through one servo.
Pé Kristì ti ṣe àṣepé.
That Christ has completed our work. God should help us.
A ní àfẹ́ gbàgbé.
He said we don't want to forget.
Orí Bíbélì sọ wípé kì í ṣe ẹni tó ń gbọ́ nìkan.
Not only the hearer.
Bí kò ṣe pé ẹni tó ń ṣe.
But they do it.
Afẹ́kẹsọ wá di olùṣe ọ̀rọ̀ náà.
He will make us a drawer of the world.
Ẹni tó gba ọ̀rọ̀ yìí gbọ́ ká mú un lò
lórúkọ
Jésù Olúwarànwá lọ́wọ́
o.
Ogo ni forúkọ yín Ọlọ́run. Ogo ni forúkọ yín
Ọlọ́run.
Jésù Kristi Olúwa wa.
Amen.
Eke aleluya. Ẹjọ́ ní kété tá a
wà. Bobby, thank you.
Bó ṣe rí náà la ṣe kọ́ lórí yẹ pé àánú ni ó yanjú ọ̀rọ̀ wa.
Lórúkọ Jésù
Olúwàgbà ọ̀pẹ wa.
Amen.
Lórúkọ Jésù Olúwàgbà ìyìn wa. Bàbá ọrẹ tá a mú wá yìí.
The offering that we brought.
A fẹ́ kẹ yà á sí
mímọ́.
Ní orúkọ Jésù Olúwa yà á sí mímọ́. Gbogbo àpò tó ti jáde.
All the pockets that is
wrong. Àti gbogbo ọkàn tó ti jáde.
All the heart that is wrong.
Lórúkọ Jésù Olúwa bùkún ẹni
kọ̀ọ̀kan. Bí
a ti wá ń lọ.
As we are going.
Lórúkọ Jésù Olúwa máa bá wa lọ.
Father, we are loving God.
Ní orúkọ Jésù Olúwa máa bá wa lọ.
We are loving God in Jesus' name.
Gbogbo wàhálà tó wà nínú ayé.
All the woes that is in world.
Pé àkàwá mọ orílẹ̀
èdè. We are not count among the nations.
Torí pé àkàwá mọ orílẹ̀
èdè yẹn. Because we didn't count all among the nations.
Àmì yóò ní ipa.
We will not have any partake.
Nínú ìyẹn nínú àwọn ènìyàn.
In the groaning of the people.
Lórúkọ Jésù Kristi bẹ́ẹ̀ ló máa
ṣe. Ṣé ṣe
ṣe àwọn ìránṣẹ́ yín tẹ̀ ń lò
fún wa lórí kóòrè. Your father, you are using for us every time.
Àwa náà ń gbàdúrà pé kẹ bá wa
pọ̀lọpọ̀lọpọ̀. Him abundantly.
Kẹ́tù da orí ọ̀fẹ́ tó pọ̀ lé wọn lórí
sí. That you pour your grace.
Lórúkọ Jésù Kristi Olúwa wa ṣe bẹ́ẹ̀.
Father, we thank you.
Jẹ́ orí ọ̀fẹ́ Jésù Kristi
Olúwa wa.
Ìfẹ́ ti Ọlọ́run.
Amen. The love of God.
Ìdàpọ̀ ti ẹ̀mí
mímọ́. Amen.
Kó máa bá ẹnì kọ̀ọ̀kan
wa lọ. Amen.
Láti ìsinsìnyí àti títí láéláé.
Amen.
Amen. Amen.